All right, I'm finally back. Man, I've done a lot of work to this thing. Dirt floor manufacturing, tree kickers. My tires. My whip lights. I've changed this bed around 100 times to figure out what fit me with this rack. I wanted to do without the rack for going to Hatfield, but I'm not going to. These Ozark Trail coolers are one that they're just as good as a Yeti. So, and this one has a drain, which is awesome. I bought the rigid toolbox, put my own anchors in. I bought these straps, these pull type straps for this cooler. That's the name. They're kind of expensive, but they're nice. They're concealed real good. They're real tight. I mean, you can't move the cooler around. They work great. Tires. It's 30 as a rack, so if it rips the rack off, I guess we'll just have to strap the rack down. But I got the Boss sound bar. Spike rear window. With the vent flips. I got some pod lights up in here for my interior lights. But I've done a lot of wiring. See the isolator. Let me grab a light. I added a second battery. I really contemplated on where to put it. I put it right in front of my seat. My legs don't touch it. And it works out great. So, I added a marine fuse panel. 100 amp fuse breaker there. That way if I want to shut everything off, I can just click that. It shuts my whole fuse panel off and everything. But I bought the isolator because I'm running a dual battery. And that's about the smartest way to do it. You don't have to, that one works. You can set it in auto, which I'm going to do. It gives you a reading right on the panel right here. And I have the dual reading right there. So when it kicks down, it keeps your main battery fully charged the whole time. Everything, all my accessories are hooked up to my secondary battery. That way if I blow shit up, if we get all drunked up one night and leave the radio blaring and everything else, which I doubt is going to happen because I'm getting too old for that stuff, but it'll drain this battery and this battery will be ready to start and get us home. So It's not really that big of a challenge, but it just takes time, that's all. I made up all my own lugs and all that stuff. It just takes a little bit of time. I made my own seat risers. So, but all in all, I like this machine. I got the Super ATV front bumper, Can-Am winch, the plow plate. I don't think that's Can-Am. That's shit. I can't remember the name. KFI. KFI makes that plow plate. It just bolts on. It's kind of a bitch, but it's not too bad. If you want some nice step bars, I made my own at first. Man, I saw these and I was like, they're powder coated to whatever color you want. Dirt Floor Manufacturing. You can get a hold of them on Facebook. I got Brad's fender flares. I think my mirrors are some Kenimoto or some cheap brand, but I made my own stainless brackets. And I got her some goggles. Some fancy goggles. We're going to Hatfield at the end of this month. Do some riding. I've never been down there. I just ride local places like Wellsville and Hillsville and all that fun stuff. But these fender flares turned out great. He had fast shipping. I mean, they were here quick. Good price. They beat Super ATV's price by a lot, I'm pretty sure. But I mean, they all come flat. You just need a heat gun or hair dryer and you form them right around there. Pretty simple. The rear bumper, KFI rear bumper. I built this just for towing, but I do have one tip that I don't know. It helps us out. We all put bigger hooks. We put the 3/8 hooks on our winches. Just it helps because some of the shackles are a bitch, so we use big stuff just to be safe. But other than that, oh, there's a piece of rubber down in there. I got the KFI windshield wiper and the Knight light bar. These little lights here fit in there pretty good. All right, thanks for watching, guys.